High drama in Mumbai and Bengaluru as the Karnataka political crisis continues to unfold. In Mumbai, Congress leader D.K. Shivkumar was first blocked from entering the hotel where the rebel MLAs are holed up. Then he was detained along with Milind Deora.
I'm outside our Renaissance Hotel and you can see here the police is forcefully taking all the Congress leaders who have gathered over here. They're detaining basically. You can see that Mumbai police personnel are here in a heavy number and they are detaining the Congress leaders who have gathered here to show the support to D.K. Shivkumar.
The situation remained tense in Bengaluru as well, as Ghulam Nabi Azad, Siddaramaiah and JDS chief Devegowda were detained when they were holding a protest outside the Raj Bhavan in Bengaluru. Meanwhile, the BJP delegation met Speaker K.R. Ramesh over the ongoing political turmoil in the state, and the state BJP chief B.S. Yediyurappa claimed the coalition government has lost majority and moral right to continue in the office.
We have given the memorandum to Governor. When Kumar Swami lost his majority, he has no moral right to continue as Chief Minister of Karnataka.
Earlier, 10 rebel MLAs moved to the Supreme Court, alleging the Speaker is not following his constitutional duty and delaying accepting their resignation. Mirror now asks, when will this drama for power come to an end? When will our netas get to work?
Well, the drama has gotten completely unexplainable at this point. D.K. Shivkumar not allowed inside a hotel. The MLA is writing letters to the police commissioner of Mumbai saying that they feel threatened by him, so they asked for police protection. He was then taken into custody and detained and sent back to the airport and sent back to Bangalore. In Bangalore, Devegowda, Ghulam Nabi Azad, Siddaramaiah detained by the police in Bangalore, and scuffles in Vidhana Sabha. It's a complete mess. Amita Balchandra joins me right now from Bangalore, my colleague who's been reporting on this entire mess all day. Amita, is there an explanation from the Bangalore police, which obviously reports to the Karnataka government and the chief minister, as to why they decided to take the chief minister's father into custody today?
Well, at this point, there has been no explanation whatsoever, because after this happened at about 3 in the afternoon, Faye, we saw a scuffle later break out in Vidhana Sabha, where the BJP delegation met the speaker, asking the speaker to take in the resignations of the rebel MLAs as soon as possible. A scuffle broke out where we saw Mallikarjun Kharge's son, Priyank Kharge, and Dinesh Gundurao, KPCC president, engage in that scuffle with the MLA, Sudhakar, who had quit. And soon after, the police had to beef up their security at Vidhana Sabha. We saw the police commissioner also arrive at the spot, try and calm all of the leaders down. We saw Siddaramaiah later, of course, who was released after being detained, move and rush to Vidhana Sabha. So this entire politics here has turned ugly after what we saw, after the protests that we saw in the afternoon. So it seemed like the police had very little time to actually go through what really happened, because soon after this in the afternoon, the scuffle broke out in Vidhana Sabha and things got really ugly there.
Well, Amita, also tell us this. We understand that two more Congress MLAs now have tendered their resignations. What are the tallies now in the government? What are the numbers?
At this point, the BJP is at 107 with two independent MLAs pledging their support to the BJP. But the Congress-JDS alliance is down to 100 because two MLAs today, MTB Ragraj and Sudhakar, have tendered their resignation. However, when we spoke to the BJP, they said that these two MLAs who've tendered their resignation today haven't pledged their support to the BJP.
Amita, I also want to ask you this. Was there, other than the scuffle at the Vidhan Sabha, which was obviously embarrassing given that is the seat of government, was there, unrest on the streets of Bangalore today?
Well, Well, that's correct. In fact, in the afternoon, we saw, senior Congress leaders, Gulam Nabi Azad, including Siddaramaiah and former Prime Minister Devegowda also of the JDS, come in and protest at Raj Bhavan. And they, in fact, sat on the streets of Raj Bhavan protesting and alleging that the BJP had a complete hand in whatever is going on at this point, including the detainment of, D.K. Shivkumar, who was in Mumbai a little earlier today, to try and meet the rebel MLAs there in Mumbai Hotel. He was, of course, not allowed inside the hotel. Also, put out a statement saying that they couldn't allow him because they had to take care of their own, their guest safety. And hence, they declared it as an emergency and didn't allow D.K. Shivkumar in. And therefore, he was detained later on. And now, of course, he's been sent to Bangalore. So, through these developments, we saw quite a bit of unrest as far as Bengaluru streets were concerned. And post that, at Vidhan Sauda.
All right, Amita, many thanks for joining us with that update. Amita, my colleague's been on the ground this entire time in Bangalore along with Neha, bringing us updates as to what's really happening. And the situation in Karnataka does seem to be getting from bad to worse. Joining me on the conversation, TM Veeraghav, senior journalist. Veeraghav, good evening. This is Faye D'Souza from the Mirror Now studios. This is obviously... not a great place for a state government to be, but the question that we have to ask is this. The Congress and the JDS leaders have been claiming that democracy is being compromised in the state and agencies are being used against them. Now, D.K. Shivkumar being detained in Mumbai, not being allowed to enter a hotel, being asked to leave immediately and being ushered back to, the airport. Do you see that in any way as a violation of his rights or a violation of democracy?
Well, I think it's unfair. I wouldn't go to that extreme and say that this is unprecedented and this kind of behavior hasn't been seen. I don't think the Congress would allow a BJP leader to come down and meet its MLAs if they were held in resort. And D.K. Shivkumar is not new to resort politics, neither is H.D. Kumaraswamy. But having said that, it shows that the BJP is putting everything it has in a state where it's in power. It's using every muscle that it can to ensure that these MLAs cannot be taken back to the Congress. And then this is the larger question then that is raised. In any case, when there has been a fractured mandate and there hasn't been clear mandate in any assembly election, we've seen situations like this come about. The question really now is that what moral right do these MLAs have to continue, in that sense that if they are resigning and they have gone down and it's so important to hold them from meeting a Congress leader because they might shift sides, it only reflects the pathetic state and moral fiber of the MLAs and of course larger the political leadership across the board.
In fact, Mr. Prithviraj Chavan is on the phone line right now, former Chief Minister Maharashtra with the Congress Party. Mr. Chavan, good evening and thank you for joining us. My first question to you is basically everything we saw play out in Mumbai today with Mr. D.K. Shivkumar. Could you explain to us what really happened and do you see this also as a violation of democracy?
Well, what else is it? See, BJP is following the principle of power at any cost. Now, we have a news filtering in right now about a split in the Congress party in Goa. I have just not verified the details yet. But what happened in Maharashtra a few days back? Two of our MLAs were made to resign and they were immediately induced to resign and then immediately made ministers. Now, this is clearly in the violation of the Constitution, particularly Constitution 91st Amendment, which Mr. Atal Bihari Vajpayee, when he was the Prime Minister, he enacted. The spirit of that constitutional amendment is that whenever any legislator voluntarily leaves a party, it is considered defection, and that legislator cannot become a minister during the term of that the original term of the office. Now, what they're doing in Karnataka is they're inducing MLAs to leave the Congress party, telling them that BJP will form an alternate government in Karnataka and all of them will be inducted in the government. This is completely violative of the Constitution.
Mr. Jhawar, I must ask you this question. DK Shivkumar landed in Mumbai early this morning. In fact, there were actually reports that he asked media people for directions to the hotel in question, which is in Powai, because he didn't know the way. Why is it that the Maharashtra Congress was not present to help him for about the first 4 or 5 hours of his dharna outside that hotel? Is there a lack of coordination right now in the Congress party?
I don't know exactly what happened, but you see, keeping the visit confidential was important because virtually many of these Congress MLAs are kidnapped. They are being held in the hotel against their wishes. And you know, there is a BJP government in Maharashtra. Maharashtra government is using all the police authorities and all the authorities to protect these MLAs. Now, it is quite necessary to keep the visit quiet so that Mr. Shivkumar, who is a senior leader of the Karnataka Congress.
Mr. Jhawar, with all due respect, every single journalist in this country knew he was flying in and at what time he was arriving. I find it difficult to believe that you kept it, that it was a secret kept from the Maharashtra Congress.
It's not a secret. Yes. The question is, there's no point of flouting that he's going to visit the MLAs because the guard...
No, that was not my point. My point was, why wasn't there assistance from the Maharashtra Congress? Is there a lack of coordination in your party at this point?
But he was not going to wage a battle there. His point was, please understand, his point was to quietly go and meet the MLAs and find out what is happening. Now, you are making it as if there is a war going on between the BJP people who are guarding the MLAs and the Congress people who should go in full force and fight out a battle, rescue the MLAs. It is nothing like that. He wanted to meet the MLAs. If MLAs are gone and they're voluntary, their own free will, then that's a different matter. But they were being detained against their will, then definitely DK Shivkumar has a right to find out what's happening.
Right. I have another question for you. Now, obviously, from the numbers and the way the numbers stack up and the fact that Mr. Shivkumar's visit was not successful at all, it does seem like...
You're not allowed to meet.
Yes, the Congress-JDS alliance has lost control of the state. Do you think this is now a fit case for president's rule? Would you...
No, I can't. I can't comment on what will happen further. All I'm saying, as JDS, Congress had a full majority. They had a surplus of almost 15 MLAs. But BJP is trying to manufacture an artificial majority by getting Congress, JDS people to resign. So that the total strength of the assembly comes down, becomes a majority party. So the governor will oblige and swear in some BJP legislator. I mean, this is completely violative of the Constitution.
Will the Congress party approach the Supreme Court if something like that does happen?
Well, we have a PIL against the Maharashtra MLAs who inducted in the cabinet. Our PIL is pending in the High Court. High Court is going to hear that. They issued notices. If need be, we will go about the Maharashtra matter, which is exactly the same. Exactly the same, inducing MLAs to leave their parties, become free citizens, and then any citizen can be made a minister for 6 months without getting re-elected.
But Mr. Chawan, wouldn't you agree at this point that given what's happening in Goa, given what has happened in Maharashtra, Urmila Matondkar has written a letter saying that she received no support on the ground when she was campaigning, given what's happening in Karnataka, that there is a lack of direction and leadership within the Congress party? You don't have a president, you haven't had a president in your party for a fairly long time now. There's no direction. Where is the high command? Who's making the decisions?
You have an election
coming up in Maharashtra, Mr. Chawan, in 90 days.
You're right. We're trying to grappling that issue. We have a crisis in the party. Rahulji has resigned as a president of the party and he has asked the working committee to select an alternative. We've not been able to do that, I admit that. And therefore, the party appears to be directionless. But each congressman, he's going to protect the rights of a party. Now, what is happening in Mumbai is a naked aggression of political power. And this is going to happen in every state. Now, I understand that in Goa, 15 out of 10 MLAs have been, they formed a separate group.
Wouldn't you also attribute it, wouldn't it be fair to attribute it? You said yourself that there's a lack of direction. You haven't been able to, the CWC has not even met to actually vote in a new president. In this case, and given the last defeat, there will be people in your party who will decide that they no longer want to be part of that party. Isn't that fair for them to allow them to do that?
You see, Everybody knows, you also know, all of us know, there is a crisis in our party. Hmm. There is a leadership crisis. The point is, there is no clear-cut second in command. There is no succession thing in the Congress party, because there is a Congress party president and there is a working committee. A working committee is always convened by the Congress president. Now, if Congress president resigned, it's a very typical situation as to what is to be done. Now, the party leadership is trying to identify somebody from the working committee or outside who will take over as a party president. And I agree there is a vacuum and is sending a very bad message down the line. But senior people are trying to work it out. And BJP is taking advantage. But I don't think a crisis in the Congress party is anything to what is happening in Karnataka.
Mr. Chauhan, wouldn't it be fair here to assume that the crisis in the party across the board, whether it is in Punjab, where Navjot Singh Sidhu is right now rebelling against the chief minister, in Maharashtra, where candidates have talked about the fact that they weren't able to campaign because they didn't receive the right support. There have been fights within the Maharashtra and the Mumbai Congress about who is to be the leader. Karnataka is obvious for everyone to see. Goa, you've got 15 MLAs right now who are pulling away from the party. There's a pattern here. Is it fair to blame it entirely on the BJP? Because they will take advantage. The truth is, there are cracks in your system. Your house is not in order.
There is a pattern, certainly, but that pattern is obvious. BJP is trying to decimate the opposition. They do not want any opposition, any democratic opposition left, and they do not want democracy, period. I mean, they want a one-party dictatorship, and we're marching very fast towards that. Now, what happened in Karnataka, what has it got to do with internal Congress party affairs? Of course, we want to resolve that. We should resolve that sooner. But trying to induce MLAs to resign and then offering them inducements of becoming ministers in alternate government, what has it got to do with Congress party? I mean, it's a blatant abuse of power. And if all of us are going to sit quiet and watch it, saying that, no, this is the internal matter of Congress party or this and that. No. They're murdering democracy.
Mr. Chauhan, I have another question for you. There is going to be an election in Maharashtra in October. That doesn't leave you with too much time. We know the BJP is ready with its campaign, with its slogans, with its entire plan, with its funding. What is the status of the Congress readiness for this election?
Well, it is not in great shape. I agree with you. But Congress party has the mass strength and the ground level. We got decimated in Lok Sabha election, I agree. But Congress party will spring back. Now, yes, you don't see activity going on in the Congress party because of the leadership crisis in Delhi, because there's also a likelihood to be a change in Maharashtra because the president has resigned. And therefore, it appears in Maharashtra also that frequent meetings are not being held and time is short. Of course, as far as funding is concerned, BJP is flush with money. This has been an extremely corrupt government in Maharashtra. And even had to remove some ministers on charges of corruption. But that's a different matter. Yes, they are well prepared. But I think we'll have to fight on issues. Unfortunately, Lok Sabha election was not fought on issues. Some emotional issues came to the front, like the Kashmir issue or Pakistan issue or Balakot issue. And there's complete vertical polarization deliberately done by BJP.
Mr. Chauhan, we understand also that there might be some defections from the Congress to the Shiv Sena in Maharashtra. Is this something you have heard as well, and are you prepared for that eventuality?
No. I mean, see, we know one thing, that BJP is trying to decimate, finish, break Congress party everywhere. And Maharashtra is no exception. And they've done it in successfully in, successfully or otherwise in Goa. Something is happening in Goa right now. Karnataka, they played it out, and they'll do it in Rajasthan, they'll do it in Madhya Pradesh. There are rumors that they'll do something in Maharashtra, no exception. They are going to use the favorite phase of Chief Minister Maharashtra is Sam Dam Danda Bhed, power at any cost. And we are seeing MLAs being threatened, MLAs being cajoled, MLAs being bribed with positions of power, MLAs being sent to jail, and all these things are happening naked. Use of power. And I think if you all are going to keep quiet and say, no, this is just a party matter between one party and another party, no, the whole country should be involved in this. The democracy is being murdered.
Well, Mr. Chauhan, while you do say that the whole country should be involved, It would be, wouldn't you say, it would be wisest for this at this point for the Congress to choose its next president, to choose a leader in Maharashtra, to choose cohesive leaders and solve then and come together within your own party. The amount of infighting that we're seeing happening in the Congress party right now is shocking for a party that claims to be up against the BJP. You don't seem ready for that fight at all.
No, you're absolutely right. I think we should have had solved it, national leadership issue yesterday, not today or tomorrow. And we're already getting late and people are getting jittery. But I have personally appealed to the leadership and members of the working committee that you are working at it. You are trying to meeting every day and trying to sort out the things. Unfortunately, Congress party constitution is not clear in terms of what should happen if there is a vacancy at the top, whatever natural vacancy or otherwise. And therefore, there is a confusion. I mean, it's not good for the party. It's also not good for Indian democracy. But unfortunately, we are faced with that challenge. And I think we'll soon try to make sure that we have a situation is repaired in Delhi and in Maharashtra, and we fight elections.
All right, Mr. Chauhan, many thanks for joining us on this conversation. Also joining us at this point, Mr. Srinath Vithadri of the BJP in Karnataka. Veera Raghav is still with us. Mr. Srinath, thank you for joining us. I just want to understand from you, it seems fairly obvious now that the BJP is involved in what is happening with this state government of Karnataka. Do you believe, really, like Mr. Chauhan was accusing, that the defecting MLAs will join your party and you will form a government? What is the BJP strategy in the state right now going forward?
See, basically, when you look at the scenario, today I think the number has reached about 16 who have resigned from the legislative assembly, but they have not resigned from the party. And now with this particular number and the two independents giving a letter to the governor supporting the BJP, I think we are somewhere around 107. And we, the government cannot survive now. The alliance government cannot survive.
Okay.
So beyond that, I think let us sit and see later what happens, how governor will take a call on this. But as on date, the government has lost, the alliance government has lost the majority. It has become a minority government. I think it is high time Mr. Kumaraswamy resigns and moves out. Because this has got nothing to do with us. It is their own party, their own MLAs, either side. Whether you take JDS or Congress, it is from their own segment they have
Do you want to explain a couple of things to me?
And also the governance.
No, one second. First of all, why were they BJP workers, creating a scuffle outside or part of a scuffle, let's say, in the Vidhana Sabha? How does that, why are they involved there? Why is it that there are BJP workers in Pawai ushering those MLAs around? Why is it that Mr. Yediyurappa's personal secretary has been seen with the defecting MLAs? Do you still want to tell us that the BJP has nothing to do with it? Why did the Mumbai police prevent DK Shivkumar from entering that hotel today?
You see, there are couple of things. One is, I think you need to remember when the MLAs submitted their resignation in the speaker's chamber, DK Shivkumar went into the chambers, made the staff of the speaker go out of the room and tore the resignation acknowledgement given to Mr. Muniratnam. And there was a very heated argument out there. See, it is within their own group. Today, you also saw the visuals of how Mr. Sudhakar was treated and pushed and pulled and finally taken to Mr. George's room and pushed up. For a talk. But the kind of physical violence what occurred there, it is really not a democratic this one. And we were not there supporting them. We had one full day program. We had a dharana at Gandhi statue in Vidhan Sabha. Then we had to meet governor. Then we met the speaker at 3 o'clock. So our people were there because of that. And these resignations, when they make, why should there be so much of commotion? It is an individual decision that he does not want to be a part of the assembly representing his people, as the government has failed to deliver things to the people. See, that is the situation. So I can't really link it to anything, and maybe Santosh and this one you are telling, maybe it is his personal capacity, or the Independent has already given the letter
take
to the
my
governor
last question
that he's supporting
to
BJP.
Yes, I want to take the last.
The Independents have given the letter to the governor.
No, I want to take the last question to Veera Raghav. Veera, when you listen to these arguments being made on both sides, what is obvious is that the real losers here are the citizens of the state, because no work is happening in that state. Mr. Shivkumar, who's standing outside, who spent most of his day in Mumbai, was the Water Resources Minister of Karnataka until he tendered his resignation along with the rest of his colleagues. There's no water in Bangalore at this point. So there's the work and the citizens are suffering. But it does seem like all decorum and all rules are being tossed out of the window by both parties, all three parties at this point. Veera Raghav, please.
You know, you started off the show with that caption on top of the Vidhan Sada that's there. You can reinterpret it to God's work is Gowda's work. So, given that kind of a situation, I don't think, I think these issues that you pick up in terms of administration, I think these things happen despite a government and despite the commotion that happens rather than because of a government. And I think this is ample proof. It is a sad state of affairs, but this is not the first time. While we lament about it, Faye, it's not the first time we are seeing this. It's not the first time this question is going to be raised. Neither is it going to be the last time that it's going to be raised. I just want to put two things very clear. I think both the BJP and the Congress would be much better off in accepting responsibility for what's happening. I think the BJP should openly admit that, look, you can't grudge us from making an effort to form a government. Yes, we are making every effort to form a government. And the Congress needs to admit that it's the internal aspiration of its MLAs and the internal fault lines between the Congress and JDS that's blowing out in the open right now. Along with the help of the BJP. One quick point. Finally, all these MLAs, several of these MLAs, if you look at their profiles, whether it's a Ramalinga Reddy, you take the profile of these MLAs, these are MLAs who can win their constituencies, or at least are extremely confident they can win their constituencies, irrespective of which party they can be. So these are not MLAs who can be cowed down or threatened or brought into submission by one political party. They have to do things of their own volition. And that's what gives them the confidence. And that's why Karnataka is such a difficult case to hold on to MLAs, primarily because, it's not out of ideological allegiance that they're with a particular party. There is a large group of MLAs who can shift sides comfortably, irrespective of their ideological, irrespective of a party's ideological position, and hope to get away with it.
All right, Veera Raghav, thank you for joining us. Srinath Sivathadri of the BJP joining us from Bangalore. It does seem, of course, and like Veera Raghav pointed out, Sarkara the Kelasa, Devara Kelasa, is no longer being followed at the Vidhan Sabha or by anyone running the state of Karnataka at this point. The BJP, the JDS and the Congress right now engaged in what can only be described as an embarrassing tussle that leaves the citizens of Karnataka high and dry. Dry literally because of the water issues, the drought, the farmer issues and several other problems that the citizens are facing. It's simply not okay.